to you.
So let's take a look here at the file on Jacqueline Brown. According to this, this isn't the first time that you've run afoul of the law. In 1985, while a stewardess for Delta, you were busted while carrying drugs for a pilot?
That pilot was my husband and I got off.
You mean they offered you a deal and you grabbed it? He did time, you did probation. I didn't hear you ask permission to smoke in my office.
May I smoke?
No, you may not. So you get off with a slap on the wrist, but all this criminal activity fucks up your shit for good with the big airlines. Cut to 13 years later, you're 44 years of age, you're flying for the shittiest little shuttle fucking piece of shit Mexican airline that there is. Well, you make what, $13,000 a year?
I make $16,000 plus benefits.
You've been in the service industry 19 years and all you make is $16,000 plus benefits? Didn't exactly set the world on fire, did you, Jackie? Jack, you're a good lawyer. Can she afford a good one's more like it? Otherwise, you'll be in civil brand 3 weeks before the public defender gets around to you. Hey, Jackie, do you know a guy named
Beaumont Livingston? Yeah? No? Because he knows you. Well, he knew you. He didn't know anybody. Now he's dead. He found him in the trunk of a car this morning. Shot. Twice. Once in the chest. Once in the head. There you go. So I guess I'm wondering, if you don't know Beaumont, why do you suppose Beaumont knows you?
Look, Miss Brown, we don't give a fuck about you. You know who we want. If you cooperate, you tell us what we want to know, we'll help you get out of this. And if you refuse to cooperate and you continue to cop a shit attitude like you're doing now, we will give you to customs and they will take you to court. And with your pride, the judge will give you 2 years. Now, you'll probably only end up serving a year and some change, but if I was a 44-year-old black woman desperately clinging on to this one shitty little job that I was fortunate enough to get, I don't think that I'd think I had a year to throw away. So let's start again now, shall we? Who in Mexico gave you this money, and who in America were you bringing it to?
I'm not saying another goddamn word.
I'd like your permission to look through this again so we'll know exactly how much we're talking about here.
Sure, go ahead.
All right, let's see what else is in there. You mind?
Beauty case.
What's in it?
Beauty products. Alarm clock. Glass case. Birth control.
What's that?
My diet shit.
Let's see what else is in there.
Here.
What's this?
What's this shit?
Charge is possession of narcotics with the intent to distribute. How does your client plead?
Your Honor, she wishes to stand mute.
Very well. Detective Varga.
Vargas, Your Honor.
Sorry. You are the arresting officer in this case?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And do you have a bail recommendation?
Yes, I do, Your Honor.
And that would be?
Based on the defendant's prior conviction and the extreme possibility of flight due to the occupation, the state requests a bond of no less than $25,000.
And the people are fine with this? I'm going to set bond at 10,000 and set the date of August 21st for the prelim.
Your Honor, when will that be?
That's 6 weeks from now, Ms. Brown. We'll continue this matter then. Owens, case 72242. Charges possession of a concealed weapon and striking off. Yeah. That is your client.